Hey, Ari's people. Moki was behind me. So, I wanted you to get, if I can try and keep these guys in camera while I'm bringing these buckets out here, because I never use buckets for pretty much anything. And I got these two buckets. And I already tried to get a picture with Mr. T, and it didn't work out too well. So I want to see how Mr. T responds when I walk out here with these buckets. And then I'll show you some pressure and release the wrong way. It's like throwing treats from a bucket at a distance to pet your horse. So Buddy saw it. See, my guys don't know. Watch Mr. T when he hears it. He's like, he's got that damn bucket. All right, so. Let's see. Messing with the horses in the morning. All right. Poor Mr. T. He's like, man, I'm old. I just want to eat my food. So, if you watch my other video, I don't know if I posted it yet. I needed a bucket like to wash my car or something. And I was like, man, it's hard to find a good little solid bucket. Now, I don't feed my horses in buckets. So, my horses aren't like coming over here thinking I got grain, because I just don't feed them in buckets. So anyway, I use my buckets to wash my brushes, to wash my ropes, to dump and change the water buckets. I have a bigger bucket than this that I can dump in my water buckets to dump the water out. I'll go water my trees with it, and then I'll spray out and clean my water bucket. So that's what I use buckets for. That's why I don't get this I love buckets, like the video where that girl poured grain in a bucket, and I said every horse knows that. Now, if I put grain in these buckets, they do know the sound of grain hitting their bucket, their feed bowl, other things. So if I poured grain in here, they would probably react knowing it was grain and a treat. So I was looking for buckets. I was on the internet looking for buckets to see where I get the cheapest price. It went like 12 or 13 bucks a piece for these on Amazon. I was like, what the hell? So then a little horsey picture came up. So I did a little video kind of like looking at horsey toys on Amazon. And I haven't posted it yet. But then I go to my feed store where I get my feed store. And they got these buckets, $4.99. I'm like, are you kidding me? Amazon's charging $12.99, I think, for these buckets. And they got them for $4.99 at my feed store. Any one I want. So I got a pink one for all the ladies that say I hate pink. Oh, look. Ooh, pinky, 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 pink. So the pink one's for Buddy and the blue one's for Mr. T. Because Mr. T don't play that pink shit. Buddy, he doesn't care. So I came out here to take a picture. This is how all this started. I came out here the other morning. It was foggy. It was nice morning. I said, you know what? I'll put these on their butt and take a picture, and then I'll slide it in when I'm looking for a bucket so they'll know I went and got a bucket. Well, it didn't go too good, and I didn't have my camera, so I'm going to do it again. So this is pressure and release the wrong way. Let's watch the difference between Buddy with his pink bucket and Mr. T with his blue bucket. And I'll leave my coffee here. And the gate's open. So first thing I did is I walked up to old Buddy, old reliable. And I put it on his butt so I could take a picture. And he didn't care. Now comes Mr. T. Buddy's like, cool. He leaving me all the food. Poor Mr. T. Okay, so that little experiment was brought to you by Alicia with her, I made the horse's feet move. Well, guess what? I just made my horse's feet move, and I still can't touch them. But Rick, you said if you make the horse feet move, you can touch them. Yeah, okay. You go ahead and believe that. Poor
poor Mr. T. Dad's so mean to him. He's like, get that damn bucket away from me, dude. He didn't. Now, see, the first time I did, he wasn't quite as aware. So I got it up there and I set it and I walked away and he was like, what the hell did he just put on me? And then he took off and it fell to the ground. And then Buddy ran because he thought the blue bucket attacked his little pink bucket. So it was pretty funny. I didn't have a video, but I figured it was a good opportunity to discuss a little pressure and release and making a horse's feet move. Because obviously, which is why I don't like the term, show 'em who's boss. Everybody wants to say that, expecting everyone to know when and how to apply that, with what degree and for how long, etc. So there's a time and a place. You can make a horse's feet move, but it has to be with purpose, and the horse has to connect why you're making his feet move. Are you just being a nag? Are you being a barn witch? Are you being a pain in the butt? Do you always be that way? Does the horse just not like you because you're nagging him all the time so he moves his feet? Anybody can make a horse feet move. Shit, they do that all the time by themselves. So making a horse feet move has to be done. I'm changing my little lid so I can know when I'm drinking. I got to keep my little symbol on either the back side or the front side so I know when I grab it, it's either away or toward me. That way I know the hole is. So anyway, it's a little bit nippy this morning out here. I think it's like 39. It may not look cold. Can you see my breath? I can see it. So, making a horse feet move. Who thinks this would be a great training way to get me to be able to pet Mr. T? Is if I just keep trying to put the bucket on him and I make his feet move. Because Rick said if you make the horse feet move, you tell him you're higher. See, you see how easy it is for things. When you're dealing with a live reactor, you know, it's not like a car. Like, look, stick the key in, turn it clockwise, and it'll work. You know, open the door and pull the door and it'll shut and latch. Those are things that kind of mechanical anywhere. Buddy's kicking. There's a couple little flies on him. I noticed that. I need to go get a some fly spray for him. I mean, I've got some. I just got to go get it and spray him. So it's so easy when you're dealing with a mechanical thing. And even then, it's not easy when you're trying to communicate to somebody. I remember talking a few times about the class when I was in college. I was taking some communication class or whatever, and the instructor made us got out a book of matches. Hell, I don't know if they have book of matches anymore. But most everybody knows how to do a book of matches. You open it up, you pull out a match, you strike it on a striker. So we had to sit back to back to our partner, and we had to explain to them how to strike a match. And the partner could only do what we said. They were instructed not to do anything that they knew. They could only do what we said. And that damn was the hardest. I was like, how freaking hard is it to freaking strike a match? And I mean, trying to describe that, something as simple, when you're sitting right across from them, and everybody already knows the things you're working with, and yet no one could complete the task. It was just amazing. And again, it goes back when you're talking about communication. You know, the old story is you get eight people in a row and the first guy whispers something to the next person whispers the same thing. And when you ask the last person to repeat what the first person said, it's totally different than what was started out. That's what happens when you start trying to explain horsemanship over an email, over a video, over at least with a video, you could kind of get some visual feedback with the audio that I'm saying so you can connect a little bit, but you still don't get the timing, you know. And a few people was like, oh, she hears what you're saying, she just can't implement it. And I say a lot, there's knowing and there's doing, and they're not the same. You know, people who are experts, mainly all your college professors who have never done what they're teaching. Never. Just about every college professor out there has never done what they're teaching. Because the people who have done it are making a living and doing it. They don't go work at a college. People that go work at a college spend their life getting a degree, telling everybody how smart they are, locking up ribbons or certificates or whatever the hell it is to make them feel good, and then they end up instructing it and they've never done it. And it's never good to be taught by somebody without experience. That's the problem with YouTube. You have a lot of people wearing pink that have owned horses for 20 years. They don't know what they're doing. They've watched a lot of videos, but they don't know what they're doing. They've watched videos on how to train wild Mustang, and they've never had a wild horse. And or they'll rescue a wild horse, and because they can feed it, they've trained it. So now they're a trainer, and now they're doing videos telling others. And then they write me saying, I watch so-and-so, and she's really good, and I watched this guy, and he's really good, and they said, and I've been doing what they say, and now I'm writing you, Rick, so you can fix, because when I listen to other people, it don't work, so I'll come to you. Are you freaking kidding me? Hi, buddy. What do you see over there, boy? Mr. T doesn't look around too much unless I'm around. So he's usually allows Buddy to kind of keep an eye on things. And like I said, they just been, man, my grass must have zero nutrition. I keep getting on my damn neighbor to feed his freaking cows, because I have to change and hide where I feed my horses, because I don't like to tease the cows. They're hungry. They come over the fence. So I was like, dude, I said, dude, why ain't you got no hay for the... Oh, you know, I might be getting rid of them in a year. I'm going to probably be moving. I'm like, dude, they don't know that, and they don't care. They're freaking hungry. Yeah, I guess I got to order them some hay. And, oh, man, it's so hard to give unwanted advice to people with animals, because it's usually taken personally, like, mind your own business. It's not your animals. I'll take care of mine, blah, blah. So it's really hard to watch horses or other animals be neglected and not do anything. And I was someone to go, call the police. Well, you don't call the police on your neighbor, and you don't, you know, there's certain things you just gotta, you just gotta ignore. I mean, you just gotta go through life sometime and go, you know what? If I wasn't here and I wasn't seeing it, I wouldn't know it, and I wouldn't do anything. So I probably shouldn't get involved. But anyway. poor buddy. Let me go bust my buddy in his pink bucket.
Skip. How do you skip? Maybe I'll do like the military. When you change step, we skip. When you're marching, if you want to get out of step, you go change step, march. And you do that to change step. But maybe you skip like this. I don't even know how to freaking skip with a pink bucket. Yay, buddy! We can get you a little harness and you can carry it around. Then you can wear it around your neck. We can hang it on your ear. We can have it ride, buddy, like, yay, I'm riding, buddy. Come on, buddy, let's go.
Poor Mr. T. That poor old man's been through much through his life. He goes, dude, I just want to eat. I don't need your damn shenanigans out here in the morning. Oh, shit.
Buddy boy, he got a pink blanket or a pink little bucket. And we'll get him a pink bow, and he'll be a good boy. Good boy, Mr. T, he's eating. Good boy, buddy, he's eating too. Good boy, he put his head down. Good boy! Look at them, they're chewing. Good boy, you guys are chewing!
Freaking people on the internet, man, I swear. Oh, shit. I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do today. I gotta climb up on that damn roof. You see that rust on that damn roof? It's a pain in the ass. Maybe somebody can freaking give me a tip before I get up there and screw that up. So, my damn, that little, I think they call it a spark arrestor. It's rusting. There's rust down the side. And there's rust all on top. And they want like $500 to replace that sucker. I had a couple people come out. It was a pain in the ass to get them out there. And so, you know, they want $500 just for a couple of the parts. And then the top part, if I want to replace that little spark rust, they want another $200. So then it comes up to $750 just to get the rust from running down the side of my house. So I'm like, you know what? Screw it. I can buy a damn ladder for $400 to get my ass up there. And I can go up there and either sand and put some of that rust inhibitor and paint it. So that's my mission. But I had to order a 32-foot ladder to get up there. And Of course, they didn't have a 32-foot ladder in because they're too damn big. So I had to order it. And it won't come in till December 4th. I'm like, great. Wait for the freaking winter where it's slippery and icy, and then I'll get up there and kill my damn self. So anyway, that's if I had a ladder now, that would be my project, because it's been bugging the hell out of me, and I'm tired of dealing with these idiots. There's one place in Gainesville. I should put this on my gun channel, because I'm always cracking on firemen. I got nothing against firemen, but you know, I got a problem when government grows and we have all these damn fire departments. Our taxes are out of control, and they sit around and they eat and they sleep and they get paid, and we got to have more and more, and it's like, that's freaking ridiculous. It's a huge waste of money, but they don't care. They're getting their pensions and taxpayers. They make as much as cops to sleep and to eat. And so anyway, so I'm kind of cracking on firemen a lot, because the only time I see damn firemen out there ain't at a damn fire. It's on the damn highway when there's an accident, or somebody freaking throws a banana peel on the highway, and suddenly the fire department shows up with a freaking 40,000 pound truck, ladder truck, that they never use because there ain't no damn fires. So they have to park it sideways across every damn lane of the highway and block people from going somewhere. And so that way they justify. See, what people don't know is for the fire department to get new trucks, they have to get so many miles on their truck. So when you see all these fire department shit responding to stupid shit, all they're doing is trying to get miles on their truck so they can buy a new truck, because they don't use the truck to fight fires and they don't want to keep the old truck. It's government at its finest. But anyway, I digress. Don't get me fired up on government. So anyway, so I crack on firemen sometime, and I kind of get on their ass when they show up to scenes and just block traffic. Well, there's a company up here in Gainesville that does North Texas chimney, and it's called a Firehouse. I think they're out of Denton. But the fire guys work out of their Gainesville firemen. And man, this dude was he didn't call me back. He wouldn't call. When he did answer my call one day, he's like, well, you know, I'm at the firehouse right now. I'm working on a schedule for the guys, so I really can't talk. Just send me some pictures. I'm like, oh, geez. He just seemed like he was arrogant and important. Like, dude, you freaking get paid to sleep and to sit on your ass and to drive the big fire truck to the you know, grocery store to buy your freaking lunch. And you can't talk on the phone, but all right, whatever. So he's getting paid by the government, and he's running his business. So I was like, okay, this guy just think he's a little... He's so used to getting paid for doing nothing that when he has to do something in a second job, that he's getting paid by his first job to, when he's taking care of business for that, he's still freaking lazy. But I digress. So he kind of irritated me the first time. So he goes, send me some pictures and I'll let you know what you got, and blah, blah, blah. Okay, so I sent him the pictures. 2 days later, he hasn't freaking called, hasn't emailed me. I'm like, what the hell? So I'm like, all right, Rick, don't go into your Rick mode, call him an asshole, kiss your ass and move on. I said, be a nice guy. Try to get along with him. Let's try a little pressure and release. I'll put a little pressure on him. So I sent him a 2-word text. Any updates? With a question mark. No answer. 3, 4 days go by. I'm like, what the hell? Is this dude just trying to be a dick? Or is it, you know? So I'm like, okay, I guess he's still working on a schedule. That's his only job in life. He's getting paid 24 hours a day and he can't figure out a schedule. It's taking him 4 days to answer a freaking text. So I'm driving home, and I see a freaking firehouse chimney out of Denton truck on the side of the road. And he's kind of like where I'm at. And I'm like, shit, I wonder if this dude's looking for my house. And this dumbass didn't call and tell me that he was coming. So I pull over, and I back up. And the guy driving the truck, nice guy. He's a fireman, really nice guy. And I end up actually giving him one of these cups. He wanted the one that said, come and take it. But I said, dude. He came out here, looked at my place. He said, I'll give you that, some all that shit. So he was a nice guy. I gave him a cup. I said, hey, man, I appreciate you coming out. So anyway, so I pull him over and I go, hey, dude. I said, are you looking for my house? He goes, I don't know. Where do you live? He goes, what's your name? And, you know, because I kind of hit him cold. And I go, oh, shit, I'm sorry, dude. I said, yeah, I said, I'm Rick. And I called your boss, and he said he'd get back to me. I sent him some pictures, and he said he was going to send somebody out for an estimate. And I said, I saw you sitting here kind of out the end of the driveway. I was like, maybe he's looking for my house because I'm live around the corner. He goes, no. He goes, I just finished with this house here. But he goes, let me call my boss and see if he wants me to go measure because I'm, you know, kind of done or whatever. So he calls the boss, and I can hear the boss. And I can tell by his answers that the boss is like, What the fuck? How did he find you? Why the fuck is he bothered? I can, you know, you can just tell over time. Look at that big old crane or whatever it is. Just flew from my pond. Anyway, I digress. So the guy's like, let me call. So he calls him, and like I said, I could tell by his car. He goes, no, I don't know. No, I didn't contact him. No, he stopped me. I was pulling out of the house. So I could tell he was getting grilled. Like, how the fuck did this guy find you? So this dickhead, even though he didn't call me for freaking 4 to 6 days on a freaking text, now he's going to grill the guy. So I almost just said, you know what? Screw it. I'll find someone else. But he goes, the guy goes, I'm kind of finished and I'm early. He goes, I got no problem. I can go do it now. He goes, yeah, okay, no problem. I'll go do it. So he goes, hey, man, I'll just follow your house and I'll go measure it now. I go, cool. Thanks a lot. So the guy comes, I call him a kid. He looked like he was 20s or 30, early 30s. And I'm not calling him a kid to be disrespectful saying he's young. I'm just, you know, as you get older, when you see younger people, everybody's like a kid. But anyway. So he comes out here and he measures. Like I said, nice guy. We start talking about stuff. He's taking rescue. I show him my rappelling gear in there because I'm doing rappelling videos on the other channel. And we look at some gear and we talk about rescue and what they use. And anyway, so just a really nice guy. I give him a thing. I go, hey, man, thanks a lot. So I'm like, man, this is pretty cool. He's a good guy. I finally found somebody I can trust. He's going to do the job. I'm like all happy. Nothing. A week later, nothing. I'm like, what the hell? I said, is this dude intentionally trying? So then I'm thinking, maybe this guy saw a video to where I cracked on the lazy ass fireman on my cop channel and he recognized me and that's why he's jerking me around. So, shit, I don't remember what the hell else happened. I think like a week later, he sends me like a text. He doesn't call. So in case I have any questions, he just sends me a freaking dumbass text that says, it'll be $400. So I'm like, well, is it going to be galvanized? Is it going to be stainless? Does it have ridges on top? Is there an upgrade? Is that $400 including the installation or is there going to be extra? Yeah, I got all these freaking questions. And he sends me this damn text. So I'm like, okay, Rick, don't lose it. The guy came over here. He was a nice guy. You liked him. I'd rather have him do it. Let me not tell this boss what an arrogant jerk he is and I'll just be a nice guy. So I do my nice little text and I go, okay, that's fine. Sounds good. Is stainless better than what you're putting, or is the one you're putting stainless? I'd probably rather have stainless. A week goes by, no freaking answer. Then he sends me a text, like two words. Stainless will be $100 more. That's his new text. I'm like, dude, you are seriously pissing me the I was freaking furious, man. I'm like, you know what? I'm not using your freaking ass. I'm tired of dealing with your dumb ass. So I went online. I went to Firehouse Chimney. I gave him a 1-star. I chewed his ass. I told him. I gave him a. You can go read it. Firehouse Chimney, I think, in Denton. You can read my little thing. It's under Buddy. And I left him a not-so-good 1-star review for jerking me around, wasting my damn time. I don't know why he runs. Why do people run a business or want to have a business like that? I mean, if you don't want to help somebody, just say, don't waste. It's so irritating when people, like, you have to call them several times. They don't call you back. Then they get back a week late. I mean, it's like, why don't you just tell? Because it just irritates people that they waste their time. My time to me, even though I'm not working, you're getting paid to waste my time. I'm not getting paid. So it's just irritating when people do that, and oh man, I'm just like, and you know, the guy that came out here was a really nice guy, and I'm assuming they have a lot of business because he doesn't answer anybody. So, I mean, whatever. If you don't need a business, just tell me. So anyway, that's trying to get my damn chimney. So after that incident, I go, screw it. You know what? I'll just spend $400, get my ass a damn ladder. I can go up there, freaking figure out how to do it, rip the damn thing off, make sure it's cocked right, make sure it's painted right, and I'll do the damn job myself. And then I know it's done right. So, if I don't fall off and kill myself, it'll be worth it. If I fall off and kill myself in the hospital, I'll be like, damn, I should have just dealt with the jerk at Firehouse. Rick, why are you so angry? Why do you... See, if I was on my gun channel, they'd be like, why do you hate firemen? Oh, firemen. I don't like their little pink trucks. Red looks like pink. That's why. Hi, buddy boy. You boys are just eating away. Man. Oh, tonight, it's the 11th. I wanted to tell you, happy Veterans Day to all the vets out there and anyone else. The sun's coming up, and tonight there is supposed to be a meteor shower. So look it up in your area for the best time. Somebody put a comment on it, and the old meteor shower, I told my Alexa, she's my little reminder, she's my secretary, I told her to give me a reminder at 10 tonight. So her little alarm's gonna go off and I'll know to go out and grab my binocs and see if I can see some. Out here too, it's nice and dark because there's not a lot of city lights. So the stars always look brighter and bigger anyway. So if there's some nice little meteor shower, that'll be cool. I was watching Ancient Aliens, man. That is such a great show. The buildings and stuff that they're finding and how they were designed and cut. And they just make such a great logical argument that we were visited by extraterrestrials. But, you know, I know a lot of people will be, there's no such thing. The Earth is the center of the world. The sun, whatever. I don't want to be pissing off more of my viewers than I already have. Hey, there's a little birdie up there in that little tree. See him? Somebody will be identified. Mom, we got some bird people here. That's a super left-wing blue-billed finch eagle baby. Okay. All right, Mr. Birdie, I'm back to the horses. Oh, shit. Somebody asked me, what kind of zoom is that? Look, it's a Sony Handycam with 30-time zoom, 30-time optical zoom or something. I don't know. Something. It's got a 30 and an X on the front. So, whatever it is. And that new battery works great, man. $10. I've been complaining about my two batteries, switching them. They always die in the middle of a pain in the butt. I was too cheap to get a new battery. Freaking, I said $10. I bought one. It freaking holds a charge forever. I'm like, holy shit, it's so much easier when you get shit that works. Oh, there's a little birdie over there, too. Look at him. I don't know if I can zoom in on him because he's kind of. I gotta kind of work the line down. The sun's in my background. What kind of birdie is he? Anybody know? Oh, he's got a big old yellow belly. That's the yellow belly bill sucker. Oh, yellow bill. That's turned into kind of a little bird watching video. Anyway, here's the horses. Maybe one of them come along. If I wasn't out here yapping, they'd probably come land on Buddy or be helping them eat their little snack. So anyway, it sounds like some people are learning from the Alicia video. I call it the Alicia video. I made a playlist for a dangerous mare or something. And if you click on one of them, it'll play all three automatically. I think you have to have autoplay enabled, but if you click on one, it'll play the next one and then the next one. That makes it a little bit easier because it's hard sometimes to find one, two, and three. And if I don't remember to put all the links and all the descriptions, then I got people emailing me, oh, I can't find one. What happened to two? I saw three. What happened? Well, I'm like, Jesus Christ, man. Everyone else is finding it. Rick, why are you picking on the people in pink that can't find things? Whatever. What the hell is my projects? What do I got to do today? I still got plenty of knot repelling videos to finish that series. The knot video, I got some good little comments. Man, I'm telling you, knots are great for... Some people mentioned clove hitch and... the trucker's hitch, any binding knot like the Prusik and the Valton Tress, I think is the name of that, called the VT or whatever. Those are all nice little friction knots for securing things. And I think John brought up, he called something, I thought it was a constrictor knot. He called it something else. He's got a little page in the comments. I don't know if you put it on the horse channel or the gun channel. Good Luck America is the other channel, and he made a comment because he's got a little page. He's into spearfishing. He makes some cool shit too, man. If anybody into spearfishing, you need to check out John in the comments. John Martin. He He's got a couple pages and he makes anything. He's got this cool little thing that when you shoot his spear and it kind of blows up, and it's pretty fancy. But anyway, John will be like getting all kind of crazy shit now. Dude, why you put all these crazies on me? Oh, shit. What a great morning. A little bit nippy. I love it. I'd much rather it be chilly like this. Let me go. I didn't inspect my boys because I was messing with the damn buckets. Little buddy got any new cuts on him? I better tell you, I don't have the buckets. You're all right. Buddy don't have any new cuts or anything on him? I got to get you guys' feet done. How's that poopy butt? Not too bad.
Oh, my feet.
Let's watch me grab his ear. Watch this ear pinning. Not threatening, but he's not gonna like it when I grab his ear. Not too bad. All right, Mr. D, I'll leave you alone. He's like, dude! Get out of my face! Poor old Mr. T. Good old boy.
Crazy mule. Oh, shit. All right, well, that's, I'm drinking my coffee. You saw the hay started out as a big pile. Ended up with nothing. Man, I just, normally they eat this long grass out here. And they're always nibbling on it, and they really haven't. You can tell I cut right along the fence line here about 8 or 10 rows in. And they're not, they don't eat the short stuff because there's no new stuff coming out. So normally they would eat the long stuff, and they're not really doing that. You can tell it looks very barren and kind of like eaten down around here. This is where I always come out and feed their hay, which is why I have to clean different spots. Because when I clean, or when I feed in the same spot, they eat the grass and everything because they're looking for all the little pieces. So then they create a bare spot. So all these bare spots out here is where I have fed them. So I have to continuously keep moving to different areas, or I'll end up with nothing but a bunch of bare spots out here. Not bear as in Mr. T Fuzzy Bear, but bear like in No Hair Bear. Wasn't there a cartoon with Hair Bear? Didn't it used to... When I was a kid, they had these four bears that played in a band. I forgot what they were called. Purple Bear Club? They were kind of big when I was a kid. I can't remember. You guys, maybe some of the old timers will know. The Bear Band. There were four guys that played in a band. Or four bears that played a tune or something. Thought one of them was Bear or something. I don't know. Anyway. Mine's just kind of wandering. Well, shit. Hey, there's a little birdie on top of the old fireplace there. That's probably why it's rusting. Your ass is up there rusting up my damn thing. I got to deal with freaking firehouse chimney crap. Look at that damn rust. What a pain in the butt. You know how hard it is to get up there and paint that shit? I painted all that shit and then now it looks like that. Such, and that little antenna is my TV antenna. I don't have cable or anything, so I just ran that and ran a wire down, and I get all the stations out of Dallas. So I ain't playing a damn cable company. Enough damn crap pushing their bullshit in. Damn, I don't watch that much TV anyway. Damn commercials are just pain in ass, left-wing liberal crazy crap. Little light breeze. You can tell the flag's barely even moving. It's just starting to move. It was dead calm this morning when we came out here, but now it's starting to blow a little bit. If it was blowing, that's a come and take it flag. Same thing as on top of the barn out there. I don't know if you can see it. See the little cannon? A little writing? I didn't fall off that barn. I fall off the other one when I was painting the... I didn't fall off. I just knocked the ladder down and got my ass stuck. Anyway. Alright, shit. I've been out here long enough. My fingers aren't cold and the coffee's keeping it warm, so normally I get run off by the cold. But that sun's at my back and it's kind of like heating me up, feeling good. Well, happy Veterans Day to all you vets. We will, hopefully we will survive. Our founders gave us a great, I gotta do a vet thing for my gun channel, but I'll talk more about Veterans Day and what a great, great gift we were given by our founders who had everything and gave it all up, became hunted and wanted men when they could have took the easy path and just kept living a great life. And, you know, kind of like everybody now is choosing just to go to Starbucks and live a great life because nobody wants to hold the government accountable. But we'll see how it turns out. All right, we'll go ahead and end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good. Oh, now that I'm on the vet, hang on. I didn't finish it. I can keep talking. I got this one buddy, and it just drives me nuts for all you vets out there. Usually, companies will give free things on Veterans Day to vets. I think Starbucks gives a cup of coffee. I think Denny's gives a free breakfast. Applebee's gives free ribs, whatever. A lot of businesses try to give back to vets, and they give free stuff out. And I got this one buddy, man. He goes to every damn... He just loves Veterans Day because he goes to... He'll eat like 5 meals today and get everything free he can at every shop. And the guy's got money. He's got more money he could buy and sell me. He's got plenty of money. But he just loves to go get his free shit on Veterans Day. And to me, I'm the opposite. I don't... You know what? I'm doing okay. And if they want to give something out to vets that need it or that could use the extra help, then I don't want to take it when I don't need it, even though I'm a vet and I could get it. So we are on totally, he used to always, when I was in California, he's still in California, when I was in California, be like, yo man, what are you doing? I'm going, come on man, we'll go. So I go, dude, man, I can't do it, man. I don't want to get free shit. Sometimes I go with him just to have a cup of coffee and I'd pay for it, but you know, or just pay the waitress the money that it would cost since it's free to me and they're working to give back to the waitress. But man, I'll tell you, man, he is just freaking crazy on his free shit on Veterans Day. And I can't remember the last time I showed my ID card on Veterans Day to get something free. Now, I do show it at Home Depot to get 10% off, but they give that to everybody. So I'm kind of like, you know, if you're not a vet, you can just be like a pro rewards member or some shit or and get the same discount, I think. And it pretty much just pays for the tax. But hey, everything's better than nothing, especially when they're charging freaking $24 for a damn piece of OSB. Don't get me started on that. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy Mr. T, you're good boys. And Moki, where's that Moki cat? He was out here earlier. He followed me around. Oh, shit, I almost kicked camera over. I can't blame that on Moki. I don't know where the hell he went. And the rabbit was out here eating, too. So rabbit's still around. Moki's around. See y'all. Happy Veterans Day.